Consciousness of unconsciousness is like the Ouroboros, where we're, you know, the snake with its tail in its mouth there. When consciousness seems to actually grow and become more refined and more in touch with itself, actually more aware of its own existence and how it can flourish and deepen and refine itself by focusing on what it does not know. All right, so ordinarily we spend a lot of time gaining knowledge. We're always greedily trying to find security by knowing more. But actually, the way to really develop and grow our capacity for conscious intelligence or spiritual intelligence is to be more aware of what we cannot know, which all the yogis have been talking about. That's what why the synthesis of all practices seems to come down to awareness of awareness. And awareness is not an object, it's not an image, it's not a thing, there's no content there. It's an activity, it's more like a verb, it's not a noun. And so we're in the presence of unconsciousness right now, I'd say. I'd say 99.9999999% of what there is that which we are unconscious about. And we, out of our insecurity and obsessiveness with trying to create something substantial to possess and grip a hold of, that we get into this contentiousness, which is very based on this grasping insecurity to look for something substantial, when it's all really void-based. There really is this emptiness, is the, you know, even in physics, I mean, it's only 1/10,000 billionth of any atom or molecule or cell that is anything we could call a particle. Atoms and molecules and cells are, the vast majority of them are empty space. So then we say, well, okay, it's quite a conundrum. How does space form things? How does the emptiness bring about the thoughts and perceptions that we have? And while that's a very interesting topic, I'm wondering if you all would be willing to focus on how unconscious we actually are by being conscious of that together, and to still the mind, to stop the mind so that we can expand into this awakening, joyful, loving, unconditionally loving, eternally loving consciousness, which is not in conflict with itself. It's, even though it's consciousness can barely be conscious of itself, even by being conscious of how unconscious it is, it finds peace beyond the need for, contentiousness. So, rather than rail against the dying of the light or whatever, let's bring the light of consciousness to our unconsciousness. What do you say, guys? Pass the mic.